Hi, so today we're just going to do a quick video and I'm just going to show you the difference between the order flow assistant and the editor. So if we start creating a photo book, select our collection, select which size book we're after, select how many pages we would like. So we'll go for 40 pages, hit create now. You'll now get this message pop up. So you've got, you can either use the order flow assistant, which will ask you to select your photos and then create the photo book for you, or you can go straight to the editor and create the book yourself. So we will go use order flow assist. Now it's going to ask you to add between 40 and 360 pictures to fill your 40 page book. I would recommend before you start adding all the pictures that you would like to use for your project into one folder and then just uploading the folder of pictures to your project rather than going for individual pictures. It will just be a lot quicker and easier for you. So we will go to add folder. Let's select our folder. So now that's just uploading all of our pictures for us. Next, it's going to start creating our project. And now you will just get this review message. So if you're happy with the book and you don't want to make any changes, then you go to add to cart. But if you'd like to make any changes to your project, then you will just go for edit. So let's just have a look and see how the order flow assist has created the book for us. So can see that a couple of pictures need editing and cropping. So I'm going to edit the book. So we'll do that now. So let's just go to edit, name our project, go continue. So that's just going to open up. So this is our cover. So if you'd like to change the title, you just double click on that and change the title of the cover. You can also move the text box around and place it where you would like. There's no photo on the cover either, so we're going to add a photo. So just select which photo and drag and drop it into the picture box. You can also make that bigger by stretching the picture box. So that's the cover. Now we're going to go through all of our pages. Just make sure you are happy with the pictures that are there. So let's just move that along. This one needs cropping, so we're going to select that, move that up a bit. So just go through all the pages, make sure we're happy with everything. If you'd like to delete a photo, if you think there's too many, you can click on the box and hit delete. You can also stretch some of these boxes to make the pictures a little bit bigger if you like. To crop your image, you would then double click on that and position that picture where you would like. Okay, so just go through and make sure you're happy with all the pictures. That one's got way too much on there, so we're just going to delete all those pictures. Click that, make that a full size picture, double click on it to crop the image. As you will see, some of the pages have got backgrounds on them. That's the backgrounds are there depending on what photo book you chose. So we chose the coastal collection. If you would like to add a background to your page, if you just hit down here where it's got background, you'll see that there are lots of different backgrounds that you can choose from. So if you would like to add a background, just click on the one that you'd like, drag and drop it onto your page. You can also add masks and frames and scrapbook images as well if you would like. Just drag and drop it onto the page. So just go through, check all your photos, make sure you're happy with it, make any changes that you would like to make. Once you're finished, just go to file, make sure you save your project, and then once you're happy to place your order, just hit add to cart. So that's just a quick video on the difference between the autoflow assist and the editing. If you'd like a little bit more information on how the editing and the designer part works, please see our next video.